an example. This is the way you play together in the offensive zone, because that's what that line has reminded me of so far in this game.
Now John Heaton and around for Hunt. He goes after it against. It's done, centered, and Franco's in the right spot. The Blues the other way. And Hoffman carries it in, fell down. Here's Hoffman, shoots. He scores! Hoffman! You called it, Painter! It might be a Hoffman night, and it's 1-1!
The whole league jumping, that's the wrister we're talking about with Hoffman. Fourth most power play goals in the entire NHL the last 4 years. This is at 5-on-5. And the defenseman, Goligoski, goes for a trip right there. That opens up the lane, and you can see the way Hoffman brings that in closer to his feet. The puck comes in, gets a lot of whip off it, and this is just a classic, classic Mike Hoffman wrister right there.
He has now picked up points in three straight, his second of the year. That's 17-25. And we are tied in one. Now Falk ahead. Oh, a break for Barbashev, but it was off his stick. Now Barbashev centers it. Here's Oscar Sundquist, backhander on goal. Fumbled a bit by Kemper. And now covered by the Saskatoon native.
Just one of those games where different players can fit into. And, you know, maybe early on it's not going to be a grinding, bumping game. Maybe it's just opportunities like that. And it's one of the reasons why I felt like a guy like Mike Hoffman, with how quick his shot is and with how big the goaltender looks, I mean, it takes one of those Vladdy Tarasenko shots, that Mike Hoffman-style shot, to beat the goaltender when he hasn't had a whole lot of pressure.
Pareko and Blake get the assists.
Mike Hoffman, second season.
And the puck goes out of play.
Pareko.
And will that be
the Willis.
Sure is. Gord Dwyer's got the call.
Arizona penalty, 82, 2 minutes delay of game.
Gord Dwyer and Garrett Rank.
Uh-oh, not good.
Right. Now things have turned a little bit here. And this
we got Blues hockey, Foxworth Midwest.
In order to avoid,
yeah, there are a couple fans there, you can see.
Sundquist, he was in a bit of a hurry to get that puck out and
not good.
The angle of his blade and flipped it 30 rows up.
Yeah, fling that up. Yeah, you can tell their fans are going to get the netting up.
St. Louis and the Health Services Department will get a puck.
Blues 0 for 1 with one shot.
Here's John Kelly and Darren Pang.
Now this side for Shin. Again, the Blues have power play goals in three straight in front of Perron. And he tried to go across the slot. Tipped away and now clear. So a delay of game to Arizona. As Crew hands it back. And a pass now, tip, but O'Reilly gets it. Finds Shin. And Braden Shin comes in. For DP 57.
Now Shin. Yeah, that arena's been since bad. 95.
One shy of his career best.
First, it was a Keel center. And it was Savage. Scott Trey. Now it's Enterprise.
Schwartz, right at Tippett. Looking for Shin. Now O'Reilly back. Shin around. One-timer Perron. And that was blocked at the defense.
Good block there by Jalmerson.
And now picked up by Goligoski and pumped down the ice.
He has been a premier penalty killer throughout his NHL career, Jalmerson has. And there, it's not that he blocked the
Blues shot, live air information report with Scott and Bernie for Turco.
Under a minute to go here in the first. Blues coming with speed on the power play. Sanford now for Dunn. And across, Cairo and Dry, right on goal, that pad save. Another shot for Hoffman, and he whipped that wide.
Keep firing at 68.
30 left in the power play. And now Hoffman again. To the back to Dunn. On for Kyrou. For Thomas. To Kyrou. To Hoffman, wide open. And it's saved by Kemper. What great passing, and he had a great look there.
Yeah, Kemper did an excellent job while reading that play. You can see how quickly the 6'4" Kemper pushed out to get on top of his crease and take away that angle. Kyrou down low to Hoffman. And there's the shot and there's the positioning and no rebound whatsoever. Here's the first one-timer by Jordan Kyrou. You don't see that very often from the slick forward. He doesn't one-time pucks an awful lot as Kemper's barking out some directions there.
30 left in the opening period. Blues with a faceoff. Thomas, after Jalmerson fell down, Thomas centers, but it was right to the Arizona player, Kajula. And he plays it all the way down.
You can be sure the training staff of the Coyotes are going to be adjusting the hollow of the skates. There's been a couple of players that have just flat out blown a tire.
Well, it led to the Blues goal. Now Dunn from center. Glove save, thrown down by Kemper. And that should do it. As Arizona is back at full strength and the horn sounds. So a slow start for the Blues. They fall behind by a goal by Dvorak. But then Hoffman at 17:25, and the Blues really picked it up in the last 7 minutes.
Yeah, but number one, I don't think they can be fooled by what happened in that first period. They have got to be ready to come out and play assertively against this Coyotes team.
Blues out shots 11-8 in the first. We go back to Scott Warman.